Welcome to this new how-to. In this how-to, we're gonna configure a flight plan manually for a Cessna airplane in Flight Simulator 2020. Before we're going to our airplane, we first need to find a route from our departure to our destination. In this scenario, I'm gonna use the online flight planner, which you can find on onlineflightplanner.org, to find a route from Rotterdam Airport to Ameland Airport. We'll specify the departure and the destination. The second thing we can set up is the altitude. The altitude has a min and a max. In this case, I've set both to flight level 050, since I want to remain on this flight level. But you can make changes to any flight level you want. As you can see, it's a very long list. We will accept flight level 050 for now. The next thing you can do is set up the aircraft, and as you can see, this list is also a very long list. In our scenario, we're gonna use this Cessna Citation 2, leave the rest of the options default, and select the create flight plan option. Within a matter of seconds, it has generated the flight plan, and as you can see here, we've got the flight plans or the waypoints defined. So the first one and the last one are both Rotterdam Airport and Ameland Airport. Now the things which are important for us are the waypoint names. So in this case, you can see the waypoint names here. Make a note of them, or what you can do is generate a PDF. That can be done via the go to files option. So let's press it. Download the PDF, and as you can see, you can also download a plan file which can be used within Flight Simulator itself. But that is not our goal for today, because we want to set up our flight plan manually. And as you can see, there's a lot of information here. So there's the destination airport, Ameland, and the airport which we are traveling from, Rotterdam in this case, the altitude, and the waypoints we're gonna use in our flight plan. So let's go to Flight Simulator and configure the flight plan. As you can see, the aircraft is already on the parking. In this case, we're flying a Cessna 172 Skyhawk. So let's press ready to fly. And as you can see, the aircraft is in full shutdown. So we first need to switch on both the master and battery buttons to make sure that we can configure the flight plan. Let's zoom into our Garmin solution. As you can see, there's a warning, and the warning is caused by the oil pressure warning, because the engines are not running. So let's suppress the error for now. You can see that depending on the options you have enabled in Flight Simulator, you will receive a message how to start the engines if you're not aware how to do that. As you can see, there are a lot of buttons on this I would say unit. The buttons we're gonna use in this how-to are mainly two buttons. One of them is the FPL button. And the FPL, as you can already think about, stands for flight plan. That's one of the buttons we're gonna use to get access to the flight plan. The other button we're gonna use is this one. And this one is the Fms Key, and it actually are three buttons in one. So there's the large part of the button, there's the small part of the button, sorry for my bad drawing, and as you can see, there's a small one here, and we'll put a cross in it. That's the button to push, so to push to select something or to select a field. So let's go ahead. So first thing, we press the flight plan option. As you can see, the screen is pretty small. Once the aircraft is in, I would say, fully started, you can also use the right unit, which has a little bit bigger display for the active flight plan due to the fact that it doesn't have all the other information like the altitude, speed, and the compass on the screen. But for now, we're going to use this one. If you prefer to use the right one, simply switch on the avionics buses and you can see that you will receive a larger one. Well, actually, thinking about it, let's switch to the right one because it's a little bit easier. You can see the same buttons are here. So let's press flight plan. And as you can see, it's much larger compared to the left unit. So to start, we're gonna press the button and a cursor will start to go on and off here. And this allows us to configure the first waypoint, which is the Rotterdam waypoint, which is called EHRD. So we're gonna use a small knob to browse to all the letters and numbers and find the letter E. So now here comes the trick. To go to the second position, you need to move the large knob, so I would say the button that closes to the dashboard, and press it once. Then we need to use the small button again to search for second letter. Then for the third position, we need to go back to the large button again. Go back to the small one here. Move to the third one. And as you can see, it found some information. It says this symbol, which, or this icon, which tells us, hey, this is an Rotterdam. And this is what we call an airplane, of course. That's what we call our destination, or source airport. Couldn't come up the words airport, sorry for that. So once we found that, press the enter or accept key. As you can see, it has added the Rotterdam waypoint now to our list, and it's time to find the next one, which is called Andik. So again, start scrolling here, pushing the knob, and then go to the letter A in this case. As you can see, if you don't start the engine, you will get the continuous pop-up here, which sometimes is a bit irritating. So let's wait for it to disappear. Use the large knob again to move to the next position. Use a large one again to move to the third one. Fourth one. And the last one. As you can see, the icon here is a bit different because Andik is not, well, is a normal for I would say waypoint. So it's fine. So let's hit enter and accept again. And in this case, it has found two waypoints with the same name. So what you need to pay attention to is the second part. In this case, EH, that one's located in the Netherlands, so we need to select that one. So press the enter key, and you can see a few things have changed. One of the things which has changed is that we can see an arrow now which points from Rotterdam Airport to Hendik, because Hendik is our second waypoint. The other thing you can see is the destination. Let's do it again. The destination from Rotterdam to Hendik. So, as you can see, the cursor is still going on and off. So it's time for configuring the fourth one, which is called Unexo. And as you can see, you can press the keys only once, or only one mouse click, I would say. Or you can press it for an extended time. If you press it for an extended time, it goes much faster to the list. Use the large knob again to move. A little bit too far. And as you can see, you can go either left or right. It's what you prefer. Almost there. Yeah, as you can see, it directly shows you Nexo. So what we can do either is go to the last character and edit, or we can simply hit enter and accept. Now it's time for the last waypoint, which is the Ameland Airport. So search for it. It's not here. Oh, a little bit too far. I'm launched again, the icon, which tells us, hey, this is again a waypoint. It doesn't identify it as an airport, but believe me, if you're going to this one, you're very close to an airport, you should be able to identify it and contact it manually via one of the other communication methods available. So let's hit enter again, and now we're kind of ready to would say to take off and to fly from Rotterdam to Ameland. So I press the button again here, which will remove the cursor. And what we can do now is check, okay, has it set the lines correctly? And to do that, we're gonna use a different button. In this case, we're gonna use the range button. And the range button has a few options. You can either turn it left or right to zoom in or out, or you can press it to the top, bottom, left or right to scroll through the maps. So let's give it a try. So if you want to zoom out, you need to make sure that you're pushing the right side of the button. And as you can see, it has configured our waypoints. And yeah, and it shows the destination here clearly. In some cases, it doesn't hover that well. And to make the hovering successfully, you need to pay attention to this cursor, which is the cursor on the Garmin unit. So, and as you can see, we can scroll. And if we're happy with it, we can zoom into it. Whoop. A little bit too far, so let's do a zoom out a bit. Go to the right side. Go to the top again. And zoom in a bit. Like I said, zoom in. I was now zooming out, so let's zoom in. go to the top again. As you can see, there's some other waypoints which were crossing when traveling to Ameland, but we didn't set them up yet. Well, we didn't set them up at all because our flight plan tool did tell us it was not necessary to do. So let's zoom in a bit. As you can see, it's kind of hard navigating to it, but it's doable. But it requires some practice and takes some time. But if you want to really challenge yourself, this way is way more fun compared to using the, I would say, built-in navigation tool or flight planner tool in Flight Simulator. And as you can see here, it chose the airport. So again, as mentioned, next step would be to take off, but that's what we're not going to discuss in this how-to. I hope you like this movie. I hope you learned a lot from it. If you like it, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe to this channel so you are staying up to date about new videos being posted. Thanks for watching.